let's learn about the structure of blood vessels. Arteries carry blood away from the heart, while veins carry blood toward the heart. Arteries and veins are different. Both, however, have three layers. Let's examine the structure of arteries first. The outer layer is called the tunica externa, or adventitia. It consists of connective tissue. Some of the larger arteries also contain the vasa vasorum, which is a tiny network of blood vessels that supply the artery. The middle layer is called the tunica media. It consists of smooth muscle, which allows for vasoconstriction and vasodilation of the vessel. The inner layer is called the tunica intima. It contains a thin layer of connective tissue called the lamina propria. It also contains a layer called the internal elastic lamina, which contains elastic fibers. Veins have three layers, but the tunica media is thinner than in arteries. Veins have one-way valves that only allow blood flow toward the heart. Capillaries are the smallest blood vessels and are very thin. Capillaries contain a layer of simple squamous epithelium and basement membrane or basal lamina. Cells called pericytes wrap around capillaries. They help with regulating blood flow and establishing the blood-brain barrier. There are three major types of capillaries. Continuous capillaries are the most abundant. They allow for some substance exchange, as they are permeable to small substances. Fenestrated capillaries contain spaces called fenestrations. They are more permeable than continuous capillaries and allow more substances through. Sinusoid capillaries are the most permeable and are found in the adrenal gland, liver, bone marrow, and spleen. Blood flows from arteries, which branch to form smaller vessels called arterioles, to capillaries, to venules, and then finally to veins as it travels back to the heart. We hope you have learned something about blood vessel structure, and see you next time.